Welcome back to the Stephen Knight Show. Aleisha Simpson is the lead singer of Heart Veil, who will soon be playing at Famous Whiskey Go-Go. Please help me welcome the very talented Aleisha Simpson. Welcome to the show.
Hey, thank you. Thanks for having me, Stephen.
Thank you for joining us. I definitely appreciate it. I was reading up on you all, and you are doing some big things.
Yeah, it's been a good year so far. We've been really lucky.
That's awesome. Well, tell our listeners about you, kind of how you got your start and how you got involved in music. Knew this would be your career choice.
I've kind of been raised with music. My family was very big in it. I had a grandma who did quartets. My grandfather and I used to play together when I was younger. And then in junior high, I discovered that I could sing and I could make like people stop what they were doing when I sang. And so from that point on, I knew that's what I wanted to do as a career. So in high school, I did all the select choirs. And then in college, I studied opera and also rock. And then after college, I started composing my own music. And from there, I've just kind of gathered people together that I met over the years, and I finally have a band now. So
that's awesome. That's awesome. So you mentioned that you study different types of music in school. Why do you think that's important? You know, you do rock, a lot of rock now, and but why do you think that's important to have the experience of learning different types of music to create your own sound?
Well, for me, I think that an artist should never be limited by one genre. I think you should be able to do any type of genre and learn about all the types of music that are out there, because you never know what opportunities are going to come. And why would you say no if you're truly, truly passionate about music and want to pursue this as a career? So that's kind of where I wanted to go.
Yeah, I definitely get that. I definitely get that. So prior to the group, who are some of your inspiration? Who are some of your, the artists that you kind of looked up to, or kind of, I don't want to say idolized, but, coming up.
When I was younger, I really liked Sarah McLachlan. I liked Garbage. When I got older, I really liked Sarah Brightman because I liked how she did the operatic voice with music. And then when Evanescence came out and Amy Lee, like, that was my hero. You know, we had never really seen anything like that, where it was this hard rock sound with this beautifully trained singer. And so she's definitely one of my biggest inspirations.
Awesome. So 2012, you started Heart Veil. Tell us about how that kind of came together.
Actually, in 2008, I had met Greg Hansen, the co-founder of Heart Avail, and we had both been doing different types of music and had met on MySpace Music. And started, and we had respect for each other's music. Yeah, do you remember way back?
Yeah, I do.
Once upon a time, there was only one real platform, and now there's all these platforms.
Oh,
so
my gosh.
It was a great, I kind of liked that platform for music, though, because it was really, they had it just for music, and now it's like, it's a lot harder on Facebook to stand out.
Yeah, and then they still have MySpace Music. I didn't know that. I released a single, and I was like, oh, I can put that on here, but I guess it's not.
They do, and apparently in other countries, it's still a really big platform. Like, in the U.S., it's not, but, like, everywhere else, that's how they find a lot of the big bands, so... Yeah.
Anyway, I'm sorry. So,
no, you're fine. And we're still actually on there because we had talked to some people in Hollywood, and they're like, if you're serious about music, you need to get back on MySpace. So we're like, all right.
So
Greg and I started composing music. We really liked each other's style. And then in 2013, we got approached by one of Spokane's biggest venues, the Knitting Factory, and they asked us to play. And over the years, I'd kind of played with different bands. And so I found my favorite members of each band and joined them together. And that's kind of how we became Heart Avail, was the joining of all my old players.
So are you all in, you're based in Hollywood right now? So you are Hollywood?
No, we're actually in Spokane, Washington. We want to end up in Hollywood, but that's where a lot of the people we work with are. So
Okay. Well, I know you all have some exciting things that you're coming up. Let's talk about some of the exciting performances you have coming up.
Okay. So I just did Sundance Film Festival, I think 2 weeks ago, and that was a ton
wow.
of fun. And then, yeah, and that was our second year doing that, and I represented the band this year. I got to party with Kate Upton. That was really cool. And then next week we're headed out to Hollywood for Grammy Week, and we're going to be attending some of the Grammy parties and
awesome.
Playing the Whiskey A Go-Go, which we're really excited about that because we've never played that venue before. And
yeah,
we're going to be playing with the Greg Kinn Band, so that's cool. You know, we're going back old school, so...
Mm-hmm. That's
and that
definitely.
It is, and a lot of my friends are out there, so I'm really excited to see them again. And then we're after that, we're going to be working on a tour, and so we're excited to do that, and you know, get out there and see more.
And how is tour life for you all? I mean, because you know, we hear so much about bands. You know, people have their personalities and they have their egos, and you know. As artists, you know, we sometimes can be a little sensitive. How do you adapt to the road and tour life?
With this group I finally have this group that we all just mesh really well, and
okay.
we don't fight with each other. We have a tour
okay.
bus, so we can all have our own space, and everyone's
mm-hmm.
really respectful, and we, you know, we have a saying, don't be a dick, and
right.
everyone has that view, and so we treat
yeah.
everyone with respect and how we want to be treated, and so it works really well. And honestly, our band, that's what we want to be. Our life is on tour all the time, so when
that's
we
awesome.
Go out, we feel like that's what we should be doing. So
right, yeah, and it all works when everyone gets along.
It does very, very well, and
yeah,
everyone takes
right.
care of each other.
That's awesome. And you're also working on a new album that'll be out March. Can you tell us about that?
We are. So we just dropped our new EP December 15th, and then we're going to be releasing our first full-length album in March. And we're going to be taking some of the stuff that was from what originally Greg and I had composed, and then we're going to be also adding some really cool pieces that we're excited to show everyone. And we like the progression that the band has made. It's been really cool. So we're really excited about that new album.
That's awesome. And that will be out later in March. What can you tell us? You know, it seems these days that we're in such a divided country, and a lot of people say music can heal and that it's something that brings us all together. Can you talk about that, like kind of how music in itself, you know, regardless of genre, can really bring people together?
I really think it can. Music breaks all barriers. It breaks
exactly.
language barriers. It breaks political barriers. It brings an emotion, like really good music. It brings an emotion that we all feel, because all of us as humans, we have these basic emotions, and we forget
mm-hmm.
about them sometimes, especially when everyone's so disconnected from each other, you know, with
right.
social media
yeah.
and all of that.
Mm-hmm.
When you come to a concert, it's like people from all walks of life can come together and just enjoy and really speak to each other. And I think music can do that. And I think it's important that musicians, you know, do that, especially in this time of conflict that we're having, that we band together and just try to unite the United States instead of fighting with each other.
Yes, yes. Can we please do that?
Yes, please. I'm tired of the fighting.
Oh, my gosh. So Heart of Avail, what do you want everyone to know about this band?
Like I said, our big thing is don't be a dick. We love our fans, and we realize how lucky we are to be at the point we're at. You know, we're not quite at the top yet, but we're further than a lot of bands
yeah.
get. And we realize that, yeah, Grammy Week, you know, it's overwhelming. Like, I have a dress
yeah.
being made in New York, but
we
love our fans, and we appreciate them, and we never forget to thank the people that have helped us get here, you know. And I think that's something people forget about. They forget you're here because all these people helped you. And so we try to stay humble and realize how lucky we are. And so, you know, we thank each and every person that has helped us be here. And we're the band that after a show, we're going to go have a beer with you and learn
right.
about who you are and what you do.
Yeah.
And so that's what Heart of Avail is all about.
That's awesome. Well, tell everyone where they can keep up with you all the exciting things you have going on. I'm sure you're on social media, websites. Go ahead and shout it out for us.
All right, so we're on Facebook, Reverb Nation, SoundCloud, MySpace, Spotify, iHeartRadio. We have a record label, so you can find us on their page. You can pretty much find us worldwide. We're being promoted everywhere right now. So if you Google Heart of Avail, you'll find us.
I love it. Well, listen, I love your energy. I know that the band is amazing. I listened to some of the music earlier, and I can't wait to hear the album. I can't wait to see, I'm sure, the pictures from Grammy weekend. I can't wait to see it all. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having us. We appreciate you.
No doubt. And listen, for more information about Aleisha Simpson, please go to our website, thestephenknightshow.com, and we'll be right back.